Hi everyone, and welcome to Four Wings Happy News Channel. So because of the recent events that's been happening in 2020, we at Four Wings thought about coming out with some positive news to show that despite all these negative things happening around the world, there's also some good positive news to know about. The first news, one that I'm really happy about, is that the earth is healing. And now that humans have been in lockdown for a long time, people haven't been driving and everything, so the air pollution is going away, the water's becoming clearer, and things are getting better. And this will be shown in this video that you're gonna see here.
Beijing before and after quarantine. Same thing in Paris near the Eiffel Tower. The Alps now visible from Milan. Another clear horizon in La Paz, Bolivia. Here, as in many cities around the world, the smog has cleared as the coronavirus pandemic imposes social lockdowns and economic shutdowns. Road traffic here has dropped by up to 90%, according to local officials, and scientists are paying close attention.
El corte súbito que tenemos de emisiones, como la otra vez una reactivación de esa emisión, nos va a permitir ver en qué tiempo, cuál es la velocidad de reacción del planeta.
Less cars on the road, less planes, and less ships. The reduction in road, air, and maritime traffic have all contributed to the improvement of global air quality. For some environmentalists, it's a sign that fighting climate change is possible.
Another really good news, one that I personally like a lot, is that of a couple who have recently just had their 67th anniversary, and because of social distancing, they haven't been able to meet, but that doesn't stop them from showing how much they love each other.
A couple celebrating their 67th wedding anniversary. Look at this husband and wife here. They aren't letting the coronavirus get in their way. Bob Schellert's wife, Nancy, is at a Connecticut nursing home where no visitors are allowed. So they had to get a little creative, making a sign for Nancy, and he's waving it through the window right there.
It makes me feel bad because I want her down with me, and I know she can't.
He's always smiling, and there's just a sweetness to the two of them and what they share.
Oh, the sign Bob made reads, "I've loved you 67 years and still do. Happy anniversary."
There's no new cases of the coronavirus, and that is in New Zealand, thanks to the efficiency of their Prime Minister, Jacinda Ardern, who is a young woman who, through her ways of reaching out to the people, have stopped the cases from rising.
New Zealand locked down hard and locked down early and went into isolation. In a bid to avoid the devastation wrought by responding too late, the country went into COVID-19 hibernation, woefully ill-prepared for the pandemic, and with cases rising fast, it had no option. It was tough, but they did it. Today, the Director General of Health had good news.
Today, we have no new cases of COVID-19 to report.
A cause for celebration, he said, while still urging extreme caution. New Zealand eased its harsh lockdown last week.
Oh, it feels so good. It feels so good. I love it. Missed it so
much. Bit of a relief.
Yeah.
Now, having faced the same threat as everywhere else, Prime Minister Jacinda Ardern has seemingly vanquished the virus.
We have the opportunity to do something no other country has achieved, elimination of the virus, but it will continue to need a team of 5 million behind it.
Aged 39, New Zealand's youngest ever female Prime Minister has a degree in communications, and in crises, it shows.
Kia ora koutou, everyone. Welcome back to our podcast. I asked a few people on Facebook and Instagram to give me some questions for you.
Evening, everyone. That I would jump online quickly and just check in with everyone, really.
She's won people over with a stream of informal live Facebook chats. This one, straight after putting her baby daughter to bed, all explaining the lockdown.
Lastly, I want to talk about another great news that happened in Kenya. There, the government have taken measures to care for the people and for from poor to rich because of this pandemic, and giving them the right to have quality healthcare. And that is thanks to this governor, an inspirational leader, and a doctor named Alfred Mature, who's been willing to be at the forefront of this change in Kenya. So that's really amazing to know about. And you can see in this video how he has made these changes.
Provision and access of quality healthcare should be a right and not a privilege. You know, the problem we have in Kenya is that it's a country of a few rich people and millions of people who are very poor. Watu wakiwa na pesa, wako sawa. Wakiwa wagonjwa, wanaenda ngambo. Wanaenda nchi za mbali, wanaenda India, wanaenda Italy, wanaenda London. Na je, maskini wa Kenya, kijana wa Kenya ambaye ana pesa, anatibiwa na nani? That is why I have decided to make healthcare a big priority of my governance. Hospitalizetu zinawatibu watu, because it is your right to get healthcare. Na mimi nafurahia kwamba you can come to Machakos, you can be treated with Machakos UHC, hata pale unatibiwa cancer, saratani, na you pay nothing, unalipa ndururu. Why? Because your life is important to me, and your life should be important to all of us. It's all about healthcare. That is why we've got ambulances, so that our kids are not born by the roadside. Wanaitwa Mwanzia, wanaita Nzelani, sijui nini. That is why we've got clean wards. That's why we've got medications. That is why you get a motivated health workforce.
We've seen the wards improve. The cleanliness of this place is quite high. And this is because of the county government. And our governors worked quite hard to make sure this place is the place to be.
I'm providing healthcare for my people regardless of your social class, because healthcare is not a privilege, it is a right.
Lastly, I just want to say, if you have any questions or you want to know more about these news channels, you just have to look at the links below. And if you have any comments or other positive news, just write that in the comment sections. So I hope you all enjoyed this 4Wings Happy News channel, and have a more positive mindset about the world.